Now, talk us through the activity on the bourse today. We did see banks and British American Tobacco really dominating trade in today's session.
Yes, they traded the most today. The banks, the big banks, Equity, KCB, Barclays, and so on. We feel that this is ahead of their results announcements. They're to be announcing their results in the next 2 weeks or so. As for BAT, I think it's still the investor excitement about the dividends. Investors want to take part in the dividends and make gains from that. I think that's why the turnover was high on those stocks.
Just looking at BAT on Friday, it was up 15% on those results, back up 5% in today's trading session. Are you seeing further upside coming through for those stocks, for that stock?
I think it will go on for a bit, but not too much longer. I think probably to the levels of 320 or so, because I feel that the rise is because of the investor excitement about the results and the dividend expectations.
And what should investors be doing at this stage with the stock currently if you evaluate the growth prospects for the company going forward?
I think BAT has a pretty solid future for it. Given the export and the car truck, which is about 14% of its total revenues, I think that going forward, that is going to really boost its profits. Mm-hmm. Investors should hold on and continue being optimistic about BAT.
Are you holding on to the stock?
Yes, definitely, especially with the dividends. Very attractive.
Looking at the overall market, we are 2 months into the year. It looks like the Kenyan market is heading for a positive first quarter.
Mm-hmm. I think the next quarter is going to be very positive, given the way it's been performing over the past few weeks. Although I think this is also because of the expected results announcements for the banks and many other companies that are announcing soon. I think investors are excited about the results that are coming mm-hmm. up and speculating on the same, as well as the dividends. Although hopefully this will continue even after the results announcements and dividend declarations for the companies.
Now, looking at Kenyan, it is expected out with results tomorrow. What are your expectations on that front? We saw Kenyan falling back about 1.3% to 7 shillings and 40 cents in today's session. The company raised its market share of total electricity sales to 58.6% from 54.7%. That was news out today.
Yes, it's releasing its results tomorrow. It will be interesting to see how they managed with the drought last year, because we expect that the drought will affect its output. Geothermal output was affected by that. And hopefully they'll have managed to succumb those challenges.
And looking at another company that's quite dependent on Kenyan going forward is Kenya Power. That company reported a 10.6% rise in its first half pre-tax profit to 3.4 billion shillings. What did you make of those results?
I think the results were positive. They were better than expected. Although they were very challenged by the costs. They've had very high costs, operating costs, because of the inflation last year. But I think investors were pretty much impressed by Kenya Power's results.
And what are you doing currently with Kenya Power at this stage? It's currently at 16 shillings and 45 cents.
I think at 16 and 45 it's very cheap, and it should be something that investors should think about getting onto their portfolios, because it's very well priced at 16.45.
And looking at the inflation picture, the numbers are expected out tomorrow. Year-on-year inflation is expected to fall slightly to 17.48% in February. We had it come in at 18.31% in January. Are you of the same camp?
Yes, I'm of the school of thought that it's going to reduce. I think inflation should come down, given the CBK's monetary policy stance and the things that they've been doing to reduce the inflation and levels of liquidity. So definitely I think that the inflation is going to come down tomorrow.
So coming down in February, and for the rest of the year, are you seeing the inflation picture improving on this front?
Sorry, please repeat.
Are you seeing the inflation picture continuing to improve on tomorrow's numbers?
Yes, I think that it will continue to improve. because liquidity positions have been improved over the past few weeks.
And if you look at the Kenyan shilling, it is sitting at around 82, 83 against the dollar there. Are you seeing further upside for the shilling going forward after these numbers? Where do you see the shilling going forward?
We expect the shilling to further strengthen to levels of probably 80, given stronger GDP growth and a better macro going forward, reduced inflation and reduced tighter policies by CBK to reduce the speculation and playing around with the shilling. So the shilling should improve to about 80 by second half.